Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Mr. Electron, and today I'm going to teach you how to make an electric generator, AC generator from an induction motor. This looks like BLDC, but it is mono block pump with a power rating of around 100 watts, 0.5 amps, 220 volts and rest the power factor. As you can see guys, that the shaft is running really smooth, indicating that there are no magnets inside and it's an induction motor. And guys, because it's a pump, these two pieces were also connected to its head, and internally they contained an impeller for performing the pumping action. And you can imagine now how it looked. Okay, so let's remove this. Now guys, at the back of it, you can see four terminals, okay? Two are for starting the motor, to which the capacitor will be connected, and these two, the red ones, are for the main winding. So guys, here as you can see that I'm connecting the meter terminals to the main running winding of the induction motor, which are the red ones. And the meter, as you can see, is pointed at AC voltage measurement mode. The starter windings are not connected anywhere, they are just left open. And now I'm going to run the shaft and hope that it generates some voltage. You can see that it is generating very little voltage, somewhere around 0.07 volts, which is very less. So I decided to couple the shaft with this cordless drill and then try. Okay, now let's hope that it generates some good amount of voltage. So at full speed, it is generating around 0.2 volts AC, which is very less. And that was because an induction motor contains a squirrel cage rotor without magnets. Okay, so let's open it up and do some modifications and then try. Now guys, yesterday I saw a video on how to convert an induction motor into an electric generator, posted by Great Scott. Yes, I follow him and really like his content, but I have a different point of opinion on the fact if induction motors can be converted to generators. Like he said that they are not useful as a generator and they generate around 2 volts or something like that, which is not useful at all. And if you want to use it as a generator, then you will have to either modify the windings or use stronger magnets. Now guys, this what you see is my custom made rotor field from an old DC armature, and the magnets are from a 775 small DC motor, and that also not the strong ones, only the ferrite magnets, not the neodymium magnets, which I'm using here to induce EMF in the armature windings of the induction motor and see how much voltage it generates. So let's try that. Here as you can see that I've placed a bearing, okay, and the black wires, I've taped them over here on the yoke because they were getting in the way of testing. So okay, it's like this, and I'm going to measure the voltage or generate electricity from these two wires. I mean, it is going to be present on these two also, but I'm not going to like measure it with a meter or utilize it. Okay, now one thing you will notice, okay, this is the winding and that's the core and the armature. Now when I'm going to place this magnet, the field, not the winding, because it contains magnets, and place it through the hole of the bearing, okay, there is a lot of air gap. I'll show you. You see the air gap, so much air gap is present, so the voltage that is going to be induced is also going to be really less. So then also considering that, you will see the generated voltage is going to be much more. So guys, here as you can see that I am connecting a cordless drill so that I can rotate the field and the induction motor can act as a generator and generate electricity. So guys, here as you can see that there is a little movement of the drill, no rotation at all, and still it is generating some voltage. So let's start it. You see that it is easily generating around 6.7 volts. Let's try and go a little more. 7. 11, 12.17 volts AC was the max I could do with just two poles. So much air gap between the field poles and the armature, and also the lowest quality of magnetic poles, the ferrite poles, and that also very small and too old from a 775 motor. And yes, I have also not utilized the output voltage from the starter winding, these two. So let's do the measurement for these also. Keep watching the display screen of the multimeter. You see, around 13 volts is the voltage produced from the starter winding. So 12 volts from the main winding and 13 from the starter winding. Now guys, this is an 84 LED panel. Okay, I haven't tested it. I don't know how beautiful it is going to glow and how much output illumination it is going to give. But still, let's see if it works or not. Okay, you see, the flickering is because the output is AC, obviously. So let's turn off the lab lights and then see how much the output illuminance is. So guys, the lights are out except for the camera flash. Okay, you can see how bright it is. Let's turn off the camera flash as well. Now, all the 84 LEDs except for these three. I don't know why they're glowing so little, but yeah, rest of them are working just great. Yeah, I think I found one more over here. I don't know much about it, but this is a little pointed towards the top and below. That is the max variation that I am getting over here. And the frequency that you can see is only 21.36 hertz. That depends on the RPM that I'm giving it here. I will reduce the speed, then you will see the frequency. You see 9 and 10 hertz, and if I increase it, 21 hertz, okay? And so we can reach 50 or 60 hertz according to our requirement. So yes, the output sine wave is also pretty good, and the output generated voltage is also very good. And guys, if we use a bridge rectifier, we can get a constant output DC also. You see, still there is a little bit flickering present, and that can be eliminated by connecting an output DC capacitor across the two terminals. You see, pretty good, right? Let's turn off my camera lights. Still glowing and slowing down because of the charge left in the capacitor. So guys, I believe that was enough proof for you that an induction motor can be converted into an electric generator, an okay one. I'm not going to say a great one, but yes, it can be converted and utilized as an electric generator. But now comes the part why it didn't work when Great Scott tried it. Now guys, let's assume that this one is one of the induction motor coils in its armature, okay, and this is its rotor, the squirrel cage rotor, and we have managed to place a magnet on this side and one on this side. Okay, so the coil is like this and the magnet is like this, and that this one is north, the magnet, this one is north, okay, and this one is south, this side. So like it moves like this, then it induces voltage. And then again, when this magnet comes, then it induces reverse voltage. So it produces pure sine wave AC. Okay, that is easy. But what will happen if we place the magnets too close to each other? That happens when we like introduce many magnets, like as Mr. Scott did. What he did was he used like 8 magnets because of which they were too close to each other. This time when it comes, then you see, and you tell me what will happen. Okay, what do you see? You see two magnets inside. So the two magnets are inducing EMF in the same coil. Let's say this portion of the magnet, the surface is north. Okay, this north side of this magnet is going to induce south on the front side of the magnet. This side is the front side of the magnet. Okay, it is going to induce south over here and north at the back. And at the same time, this is having south on its surface, the other magnet. So this magnet is going to induce north on the front and south at the back. So they both are going to fight each other, and whichever is a little stronger than the other one, that is going to override the other one. And the difference between the strength of magnetism is the only available magnetism that is going to induce voltage in the coil, and hence very small output generated voltage. So guys, I hope you learned a lot from this video. Keep supporting and learning. Thanks and bye bye.